All right, Orange Knight, thank you so much for sending on in your track. Again, any feedback would be appreciated. Go ahead and put in the chat what you like and what you think could be improved about this track. Also, any questions for Orange Knight, go ahead and put those in the chat as well. Any questions for any of the artists' tracks that we're reviewing, feel free to ask questions as well. As once again, this live stream is to help you guys with your productions and help you walk away from this stream with at least one tip that you can use after watching. So, definitely love the vibe that you had. I love that doom, 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 doom. I gave a nice kind of future bassy vibe, kind of a moodier type sound, and I think that really works for this style that you're going for. What I really think can be improved about the song is definitely the arrangement and the mixing. That's definitely what can be improved about the song. Let's see, there's a few pieces of feedback that I want to go over. Thank you for commenting, actually, Hemuzu. Definitely make the kick smack more, I think, and the build-up could use some energy for sure. Maybe some other elements in it as well, but not too much. Definitely, definitely, definitely the kick could smack a bit more. And again, this just goes down to overall mixing of your track. Now, arrangement, as I think the most important thing that you should focus on at this point in time. I have an idea for a full screen rant that I'm going to go on. I'll hold off on that for a minute here and get more through more of the feedback. Yeah, your song just reminded me of this full screen rant that I want to go on that I think will be helpful to many people. So, okay, arrangements. Check out this tutorial that I put in the chat. As a link to a video that I made that will definitely help with your arrangement. I think is just the phrasing of your song, the interest in your song, the elements coming in and out wasn't quite, it didn't quite flow well enough, and it didn't quite have the requisite elements to keep a listener interested from start to finish. And by following this tutorial, you'll be able to understand what can go in the different sections of your track and when to take them in and when to put them in and when to take them out. So definitely check out the tutorial and apply the tutorial, and I think you'll find that your arrangements are much more interesting and much more professional. Alrighty. What else? Actually, Hemuzu also says a small change in the melody, perhaps, as well, but the idea is super solid, mate. Yes, definitely, the melody idea is definitely interesting. Adding in variation will help there. And that arrangement tutorial will help you out as well, about knowing where you could add arrangement, or where you could add a variation in your track. Definitely a little extra variation and other elements to help the back and forth movement. And again, variation can really come in many different sizes. You can have very small variation to elements. Let's say you have a hi-hat pattern and you just kind of change around a few of the patterns. Just like it goes. You could just have one that goes. Just a very small variation. You could be something like reworking an entire melody, having a different melody playing. You know, again, variations can come in all different sizes. They don't have to be big changes. They can be very small changes as well. And that'll create interest in your song. And Nate, mate, that is true. Sonybox does have a sale with a lot of their stuff under $100. And I forgot to mention at the beginning of the live stream. Forgot to mention this. Right in front of me and I forgot it. We are doing the free giveaway in this live stream. That is right, these Sonyvox Orchestral Companion strings will be yours for free once we hit 40 concurrent viewers in this live stream. Again, 40 people in this live stream, we will run the free giveaway and someone will win this plugin, this $69 plugin will be yours for free. Love Sonyvox stuff, very, very good quality. A couple weeks ago, we gave away the Orchestral Companion Brass. Love all their stuff. It's definitely a plugin that you want. Strings work well in so many different types of genres. Really, all electronic music, strings can find their way into those tracks. Let's see. Nice! Glad you found the gain staging video helpful there, actually, Himuzu, as well as gain staging. Gain staging can definitely help with this song as well. I'll go ahead and leave a link for that for you guys to check out. Gain staging, it is right here. Boom, 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 boom. Again, in the chat. Just put it in there. All right. Getting the viewers is hard. It is hard, especially since I have not been consistent with the live stream as of late. I've had a lot of inconsistencies with it, just not streaming at the same time every Friday. But we can do it, guys. Invite your friends, and we can get this live stream giveaway going. We're at 11 right now. All we need is 29, and we are there. Okay, so the full screen activation. We are here. So, listening to your track, Orange Knight, I mean, this is a very common problem for many producers, and really something that I struggle with too. Unless you're, you know, a professional producer producing on a high level, you probably have this problem to some degree. To create a professional production from start to finish by yourself, meaning you doing the entire production process, coming up with the idea, refining the idea, mixing it, mastering it, is incredibly difficult. Each one of those things that I talked about, each can take years to become proficient at. Really just writing songs, coming up with melody ideas, just engaging in musical passages. That in itself can take a long time to hone that skill. There are a bunch of tutorials online, just different courses that you could take, and you can go down a whole rabbit hole and spend all your producing time that you have just working on creating musical passages, meaning coming up with chord progressions, harmonies, melodies. And that's just one part of the production process. What about the arranging part of this? What about the mixing part of it? What about the sound design part of it? Again, all these different sections have, they're incredibly, incredibly deep topics and can take you just years to really become proficient at. And when producers, intermediate, and especially beginners, you know, they're working on tracks, they don't have competencies in all of these areas. If you are just good at sound designing, that does not mean you can make a professional song. What about the writing? What about the mixing? If those don't work together with your sound design, you're not going to have a professional track. Well, you spent all your time with sound design. You spent just years working on sound design, watching tutorials, just really trying to hone in on the sound design. That's why it's so difficult, because each of these sections takes so much time to become more proficient at, that you're really spreading your time across all these different competencies, all these different areas of music production. And it can be quite frustrating, because if one part of that chain is not working, if you're not that proficient at one part of that production process, your production might not be professional. You could have great ideas, but if it's not mixed that well, then it's really not going to be, you know, a solid professional production. Time. Time and patience, I guess, is the moral of this story here. You're not going to become a professional producer in a couple years. It's just not going to happen. Everyone wants to have a professional production right now that they can get to, but it's going to take time. That's really it. It's continual work on your music productions in the different areas of the production process is what is going to finally allow you to create a professional song. So don't get discouraged if you're not quite there yet. especially for beginning producers. You will improve. You will get better. And again, even for intermediate producers, I still have problems with this. You know, I think one of my weaknesses is just writing compelling musical passages, melodies, harmonies, chord progressions. You know, I still find that to be a little bit of a weakness of mine. You know, I've been producing for 7 years. So it's really just spending the time, putting in the hard work to improve. There are so many YouTube tutorials out there to learn all of this. You know, you just need to take time to find these tutorials, put them into practice. You know, I get so many emails all the time saying, you know, oh, what's a good tutorial for this? What's a good tutorial for that? I'm like, have you looked at YouTube? And they're like, no, I haven't looked at YouTube yet. You know, spend the time. I think you're not going to get it now. You're not going to get it now, but with time, you will make it. Very true, Lee Khan. You never stop learning. So that is the end of my rant there. Just a little glimpse into that. Ooh, totally forgot. The screen on the live stream here is a little bit off. Let me change this. Range display. Boom, scaled. Should be better. I always forget to change that. All right, sweet. All right, let's move on. That was a long time on the first track there. All right, Phantom Freak, you're up.
I didn't mean to disturb you.
Nice as always, Phantom Freak. Loving the old school rave stabs in there. Always works so well for bass house, G house. Bam, 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 bam. I am at a rave. Okay, so any feedback for Phantom Freak, go ahead and type away in the chat what you liked and what you think could be improved. Again, I love the old school rave stabs you had in there. Worked really well in this more modern day genre. Nice overall. I enjoyed the progressiveness of the track. Definitely agree as well. Nice interplay between the basses, the rave stabs, a good groove. All that worked really well together. I'll hop right into the feedback here. What I think could be improved about the song is, I think, you know, again, this comes down to, you know, your breakdowns. You know, maybe I've just heard so many of your songs. I think... I mean, it's the style or genre. I mean, what I'm trying to say is I feel like some of your songs are just too formulaic. But, you know, again, that is the style or the genre that you're working within. So it's not like, you know, you need to reinvent the wheel every song. But, you know, I just think, I think maybe mixing up the arrangement a bit could help. Because it seems like you use mostly the same arrangement every single time. Maybe every now and then change it around. Add a new section in there that is just different. You know, put the breakdown somewhere else. Do like a fake breakdown, fake build up. Do something like that. Maybe just, again, to give it a little more interest. You know, again, you know, that is part of the style. So I guess, you know, it's not that big of a deal. I will say, though, you know, with the breakdown, you know, I definitely want to hear more interest in the breakdown again. It just kind of feels like a lull at sometimes in some of your breakdowns. And, you know, that's, you know, it's definitely the part of the song, you know, when you're in the club. And, you know, people, you know, kind of just swaying side to side, you know, and they're waiting for the next, you know, drop. But I think it could be more engaging, that part of the breakdown. Just your breakdowns in general. You know, I mentioned this last time that it could be more engaging. You could add in some more melodies, that sort of thing. Yeah, I just definitely think that melodies in this as well. So specifically what you could do, at least what I heard when I first heard the breakdown here, is just kind of embellish on the melody that you already have. So it's da-na-na. So it's playing the same exact melody that the bass line is kind of playing here. I just add in a few notes, add in just, you know, a little more excitement. Da-na-na-na-na-na. You know, just add in crazy notes or something like that. Again, to keep the, you know, think about the dance floor when the crowd is, you know, kind of just swaying side to side after rocking out to your first drop. You know, think about just getting that interest in there, getting them a little more engaged, you know, to what is happening in that breakdown section, rather than just have it be a lull or a break in the action in the club. What else? Also, last thing I want to mention is the stereo imaging of your track. While you could hear all the elements, it felt a bit, I guess, maybe... I would like to hear more three-dimensionality in your track. Specifically coming from the stereo part, just the stereo field. I think the stereo image could have been worked a bit differently with the different elements in your track, specifically the rave stabs. I think the rave stabs could have been wider in the mix, because you have a lot of elements that are playing more into the center of the mix, and I think maybe playing around with the stereo field a bit more, think a bit more about width. I think that is what your tracks could benefit a little bit more from. You know, the kick, the snare, the sub, the bass line, having those in the center for your club tracks, definitely I would keep those more monocentric most of the time. And you can have the basses a little bit more stereo spread, that sort of thing. The clap could go either way. The hi-hats also, you know, specific hi-hats, the offbeat hi-hat could be centered, could be spread a little bit. But, you know, other elements, I think finding a way to make them complement the mono part, the mono elements, could really help, again, with the larger-than-life sound of your track. And, you know, with stereo imaging, I kind of feel like it's just a puzzle. You're just trying to fit in elements to where they sound, you know, big, fat in the mix without being washed out or too narrow or too wide. And it's really just messing around with stereo imaging on different elements. And again, it's just like a puzzle trying to put it together. So specifically the rave stabs, I think, could be wider in the mix. Think about spreading some other elements in the mix. You know, yeah, just that's what I think could work. There you go. That is exactly it. So you need to spread the thickness. It's too thick in the middle. You need to spread the thickness out to the sides of the stereo field. Give the stereo field that thickness as well. Another thing that you could play with here regards to stereo imaging is having those low mid-range frequencies in the sides of the stereo field. You'll hear a lot of people talk about, oh, you should cut the sides of your stereo field on all your elements up to like 200 kilohertz, 200 hertz. I don't always agree with that. A lot of weight, power, and width can be added to your song if you have those low mid frequencies in the sides of your stereo field. Mess around with a mid-side EQ and boosting some of these frequencies in the sides of your stereo field. It's not always beneficial to cut them. That sometimes weakens your mix. It can very easily destroy your mix if you add a ton of side information in that like 200 hertz range. Don't get me wrong. It's a very, very touchy area, but done right can definitely add power and width to your song. So keep that in mind when you're EQing as well. Something to think about there, Phantom Freak. Hopefully that helped at least a little bit. I feel like I'm running out of stuff to say on your tracks at certain points. Actually, not really. I mean, I think I'm just giving you smaller tips now. Just smaller tips that I see. You know, because you've been in the stream so many times, so I know your songs, and, you know, they've improved a lot, so it's like you don't have a huge gaping problem in your track. Not that that's a bad thing if you do have, you know, other problems in your track, you know, if you're not experienced as a producer. Again, that's not a bad thing. That's just, I guess, I tailor the feedback to more to who sends it in. You know, if you get a really quality production, you know, I'm not going to try and pick apart, you know, oh, the main melody of it, you know, you need to rework this and add notes here. And if it works, you know, and it works well, then, you know, I'm not going to say change it. Just smaller things to take your track to the next level could really help. Oh, that's so sweet, Phantom Freak. That is so sweet. That is so sweet. All right, who do we have next? Who do we have next? We have someone. Bradley, are you in the stream? Bradley. I don't think I saw you in here. I forgot. Wait, it's you, Nearfar Official, right? I remembered it was you. I did not remember it was you when you first came in, though. Yeah, man, always love listening to your tracks, Phantom Freak, so it's always good to have you a part of the stream every week. It's been a while now that you've been in the live streams. It's been, I don't know. I feel like it's been over a year. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Love the melody work as well. That's really what stood out for me. Definitely love that, really, you know, it's just like future bassy, like melody, like, I don't even know how to describe it. Like that just slick, bubbly melody with a lot of pitch bends and stuff like that. That works really well. And the chords that you had in there worked really well with it. Just the whole vibe. So good job there. So you have questions about the stereo field of the song. Would you suggest a wider approach on the chords? No, I would not. It is definitely very wide in the mix. You could definitely hear that. It might actually be too wide, in my opinion. What exactly did you use to widen the chords specifically? Someone also mentioned that the chords sound a bit thin. Leecon Official. I definitely agree with this. I definitely think another layer is needed here for the chords. Websar, thank you so much for the follow. Do appreciate it. Hopefully you're enjoying the live stream. If you want to get your track heard, send it on over to daniel@soundshockaudio.com. And we'll have a chance to listen to your song. And this shirt is just fucking... This like microphone is like giving me like a deep V, and it's like really annoying. Sorry, I just started. I have like a 3 second, 2 second delay on my live stream. So I looked at the video of me just doing that, of me just spazzing out. Yeah, I'm back, guys. I did not lose it. Okay, what the frick was I saying? Oh yeah, the chords, thicker, mid-range. You're missing some mid-range in your track. You can definitely hear that. You have the sub, you have all the high frequencies, you have the kick, you have the snare going, but it's missing that like 150 hertz to like 500 hertz range meat that provides the weight and power for your song. I just think taking that synth layer that you have, putting it down an octave, EQing it a little bit, saturating it maybe a little bit, and mixing that in with your chords will help give that mid-range and make it sound less thin. So that's really just adding another layer of meat is really what you need there. Yes, the synth on the chords. What else? Nazareth says, I like progression, but the lead feels way too dense, and the offbeats feel like they lose the feel of the song. You should add contrasting bits of space with intricate melodies and simplified sections. Look at your melodic phrasing so it resolves with the chords. Excellent point, Nazrez. I was going to say something like this, but not nearly as detailed and nearly as eloquent as you had put it. Really, actually, I was only going to say you need contrasting like bits of space with more of the melodies. That's really, I was going to say you need more space in the mix. That's what I was going to say. One, that would add a lot more interest. And two, like Nazrez said, you know, it'll just sound more complete. And, you know, again, having, you know, the melodic phrasing resolve with the chords, you know, I didn't catch that, but definitely I can see that really improving just the structure of the melody, really. And also having those sections where you're putting in, like, intricate melodies, you know, help break up the drop that you have. I felt like it was a little bit stagnant at times. Like, I liked the melody, but it was a bit stagnant, it felt like. It felt like it kept rolling on, and having, you know, a break from like the drums and the sub where you have, you know, an intricate melody playing will give the sense of progression in your track. So I think that will really help. Or I used EQ, a double layer chord. I think slight pan, one layer L, one layer R, like 5 to 8%. Gotcha. Mm-hmm. I guess that is true, Nate Mate. That is what someone who lost it would say. You're right. Right, good point, Nasrez. If you play tons of notes, they start to lose their individual meaning. Very good point. Nasrez is definitely the go-to guy to talk about the structure of your musical passages. Much better grasp of music theory than I do. What else? What else do I think could be improved about this song? I feel like I had something else to say. Someone mentioned that the snare could cut through a bit more. I think this also maybe had to do with just some of the width in your track. This is back to the drop. Also in this section, I feel like the chords come a bit bigger in the mix. The lead also sounded like it had some muddy frequencies in like the 250 Hz range. I think some notch EQing could be done there. You know, of course you want the lead to be front and center and bright in the mix, but it feels like maybe the chords are kind of in the background compared to the lead. And you kind of want to have them in the foreground, you know, obviously again the lead on top, main event. But the chords kind of been brought up a bit. So I just think the overall gain staging of the main synth elements could have been improved to create more impact. Also, I think maybe overall the kick had been a little bit louder. Very small adjustments. Yeah, just a little bit louder. Right? I felt like I was playing a Sonic game after it. I can definitely see this in like a video game. Okay. Okie dokie. Yeah, so hopefully that feedback helps there, I am Fox. Hopefully that feedback helps. And we will get on to Lee Cone. Get on to Lee Cone. Track. Lee Cone's track. Let's go.
Hey.
All right, nice. Nice little mashup you got there. Added in your signature Moonbaton style there. Leecon's good to see. So any feedback for Leecon, go ahead and put that in the chat. What you liked, what you think could be improved about this little edit here. It definitely worked well on the dance floor. Hopefully you can DJ this out at some point. Leecon, that'd be cool to see the crowd's reaction. Okay, so... I'm trying to think. So I like the Moonbaton drums that you added. I thought that worked really well. And you also added that, like, sub bass, right? I mean, I don't really have much to say, honestly. I mean, you did kind of like a minor edit to it. You did the bass, you did the drums. The timing was like a little bit, I guess, kind of different. Just because you had the drums in there, the Moonbaton drums. You know, all the synths are, you know, the ones that Zomboy created. They sound good. Like all this is kind of the same. But you have the intro that's different. I mean, it all sounds pretty good, man. Like, I really don't have much to say about it. I mean, you kept the kind of the arrangements fairly similar. Obviously, you know, you have the drums and the bass. Patterns different. It all works. It all works. Just, you know, a small edit that you made, I think, worked well. And will fit right in with your sets. I'm trying to think what else to say. You know, like, I never have a track where I don't have feedback that I think was stuff that I think could be improved. I guess the only thing that I could say, you know, upon listening to the original here, it felt like there was more room for the track to breathe a bit. It felt like in your track, the bass and the drums that you added took up a bigger part of the frequency spectrum and just overall mix with how loud it was. Not that it was over, like, too loud where it was just imbalanced, but if you listen to the energy levels, let's see, let me turn yours down a little bit here. Oops. I guess the Moonbaton style, the bass is bigger. This is a dubstep drop, so the bass is pretty big in this. They should be pretty big in this in general. I don't know if I'm just making something out of, trying to make something out of nothing, but this mix sounds cleaner. This mix sounds cleaner, and I think you could EQ your drums and bass a bit better so it blends a bit better with the dubstep synths that are in here, the dubstep bass, mid basses that are in this track. Listen to the low end of this track and listen to the clarity of the other elements in the mix. I think that's really what maybe you should focus on when you're mixing in your drums and your bass, is not so much the power, I guess, because Moonbaton, you know, you have that big 808. This dubstep track doesn't have that big 808, so I think you definitely want to have a little more energy in the low end in your track, just based off the style. But I think the clarity in your track of the overall elements could have been a bit better, specifically in the synths, Again, listen to the synths. You can hear a little bit more in detail what they, just the timbre of the mid basses. And I think that, again, has to do with the mixing a little bit of the low end and the drums. So I think adding more clarity to the synths by EQing the 808 and drums could improve here. I don't think I actually made, well, okay, I definitely felt that when listening to this track. I felt like I'd hear the mid basses a bit better. So I don't think I made something out of nothing. I definitely think, yeah, some just a little bit fine-tuning specifically the drums and bass that you added could help with this overall track. All right, sweet. Can't listen to a song and not at least give some feedback that could help. That would not, wouldn't be good for business, would it? Wouldn't be good for business. All right, Nate Mate, we are up. But yeah, also, I guess I don't receive as many, I guess, like, edits as well. I usually receive remixes or I receive, you know, originals. So I guess, I just receive mostly different types of productions. I guess maybe that is why it was a little bit harder to give feedback on edits specifically. All right, Synth Storm is up. Nate Mates, thanks for sending on over your bootleg of the classic Sandstorm. So any feedback for Nate Mate, go to put that in the chat. What you liked, what you think could be improved about the song. So again, love Sandstorm, love remakes of Sandstorm. Many different directions you can go with the song. Love the little kind of trancey, hard style-ish influenced track. Definitely think that the drums, specifically the kick, could be a lot more powerful in the mix. That is a driving force of your song. You have that hard style type kick in there. Why not have that be more powerful in the mix and really drive the rhythm of your song? Have that be the heartbeats. You want to hear the heartbeat of the song a bit more here. Also, the drop that you had going here, in my opinion, kind of fell flat. You had all the build up of the classic Sandstorm. Had the little arp come in. Had the melody come in. Start picking up the tempo. Have this kick come in. Have the "Are you ready?" And then it kind of just, it dies a bit there. I think reworking this section to make it more impactful so the listener is ready, you know, is getting that excitement, that energy from the section. We could do, let's see. That main lead here. Dun, 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 dun. Have that build up with the section here maybe, or just bring it in. Oh, Or maybe I would just have the main have that lead playing right when the drop hits, more transition effects, more filtering on this section to really create a swell up type effect on the buildup would be beneficial, I think, for the overall impact of your drop. And really, there's not much of a sub in there. I think you need more of a sub and mid-range bass to really add more weight to this song. I think that would really beef it up a bit. I think compressing the bass and the kick together, that will also help strengthen the groove. Just doing those things that I mentioned, I think will definitely help with the overall track. Again, the kick louder, more impactful. Have a sub layer, have a mid-range layer, maybe just bring up the layer that you already have for the bass, is what I'm talking about. Compress the kick and the bass together. I think just doing this, that will make your track a lot more impactful. Again, work with the build-up here, more automation, effects, auto filters, all that sort of jazz. Put that on there to really create a swelling type effect. And adding in maybe the main Sandstorm lead right when the drop hits, that could work really well. And doing just that will just make it much more impactful, I think. And I really believe that you'll like the results if you apply some of that feedback. So hopefully that helps there, Nate Mayton. Thank you for sending on in your tune. Moving on here. We're moving on. Hemuzu. Let's get it started. All right, hell yeah, Hamuzu. Loving it, man. Great work on the tune. Absolutely love the arrangement of the track. I thought that worked really well. Also the style, future bass-ish kind of, mixed with that hybrid-ish style trap. Works really well together, compelling from start to finish. So thank you very much, actually, Hamuzu. Good feedback there. I read books, 1, 2, 3. Definitely have some commentary on the low mids as well as the lows of the track that I'll get to in a second. Are you sure you do not have a reference track here, Hamuzu? I'm trying to find one here. I think Lime has kind of this sort of style. Let's listen to a few tracks. Maybe you can find one that's kind of similar-ish. Okay, so I mean, kind of ish. I mean, I guess the main point I want to try and get across maybe with Lume's tracks is kind of the style of mixing. The mixing is the thing that needed to be improved a lot in your mix. What? The mixing is the thing that needs to be improved in your mix. That made a lot of sense. Yes, just the mixing. The mixing could be improved overall. Few things that I think could be improved here. One first, let's see, the bells. I think those could have been deeper in the mix. I think they're a little too sharp in the mix. Reverb, delay, wash them out a little bit. Don't make them so, I guess, in your face, I would say. I think that would work better just for the overall mix and for the vibe of the song. The kick sounded a bit muffled. I think it could have been less muffled, I would say. You know, pop, 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 pop. Something a little more high-end, I think, could work really well for this track. Really cut through in the mix. And then, secondly, I don't think the 808 was too loud at all. I just really think it could have been raised up a little bit. It seemed a bit low in the mix. And I also think it could have used really some more saturation, some more beef to it. So, it had, you know, you had the sub in there. I don't know if it's a specific note that you're playing in the track for the specific sub notes, but sometimes it feels like the sub disappears a little bit. It gets kind of weak. Again, that could just be the note that you're playing. There's only a certain number of notes in four sub basses that can be played that give a really strong, powerful feeling. If you go too low, it just becomes inaudible and you can't feel it at all. If you go too high, then it just really just, you don't, the sub frequencies don't ring out. So again, there's a very small range on your in a specific octave for sub basses. You know, it's very small. That's why a lot of dubstep producers write their tracks, and a lot of trap producers write their tracks in F, in the key of F, because F0 or whatever, you know, the sub bass is F something, that is the strongest sub note. I believe it's F sharp, actually. F sharp is the strongest sub note. It is, you can feel it the most, it has the most power. Yeah, I think it's some notes are a little bit too low. And maybe try reworking some of them. See if you could add in a different note there. Sometimes you won't be able to because it just doesn't work with the song, but see if you can. That could help. Again, also adding in another like mid-range layer where it's like you take your sub, copy the channel, pitch it up an octave, take out some high frequencies, take out the sub frequencies at like 80 hertz or so, saturate it, stereo spread it a little bit. That can give you more of a mid bass that plays along that is a layer for the sub bass. That could work well for this type of track. Probably, if you raise it an octave, it'd probably sound weird. I mean, it wouldn't sound weird, it just wouldn't have the low-end power that you need. So, now going back to LeMay's tracks, listen to this track. What you could do here is I would listen to this track, download this track, put it in your DAW with your project, or open up a new project, a blank project, put your track, bounce your track down to a WAV file, put your track in, put LeMay's track in, put them close together in volume, very close together in volume, and put a high cut filter on, both of them at around 400 hertz. Listen to the energy that is coming from LeMay's track with this high cut filter on, and then listen to your track with this high cut filter on. You'll hear that 400 and below in LeMay's track is much more solid, it's much more impactful. With your type of track, that's what you need. That power and weight in the sub frequency, in the mid range, is very important for the success of your track. It's a club track, it's a festival track. You need it to have that power. And I think your track is missing some of that power. Part of that is gain staging, part of that is the sub. A big part of that is the sub, really. And again, changing around the notes, see if you can change them around, add in that mid-bass layer. Kick could also help with that as well. I think overall your kick seems to be okay level. I think actually a new kick. I think a kick, you're cutting out some frequencies in your kick, it feels like. It feels more like a poof, poof. Not so much of a boom, boom. So I think, yeah, a new kick. Yeah, it sounds like you're cutting out low frequencies in your kick. Something that has more lower frequencies would work. Yeah, you could also do that. I've never really used match EQing, to be honest. Yeah, I don't even know if I have a match EQ. Doesn't Logic have a stock match EQ, right? Do not cry, actually, Himuzu. Again, time. Time and patience and practice and persistence is what will get you to producing on a professional level. Also, I want to take this time, you know, as I was looking for the artist that came to mind when I was listening to your track to find a potential reference track, I was going through the interviews on my site. You know, most of you know Soundshock Audio, of course, for the free downloads. Soundshock Audio has the largest free collection of music production resources on the web. The largest. That is right, the largest. That's not a joke. It is the largest. You cannot find one that is larger. Also, sample packs, presets, and music production apps, and DAW templates, I have the most out of any other website on the web. There are other sites that have more plugins than I do, but those three categories, no other site has a bigger library. That's not the point I was trying to make. The point I was trying to make was the interviews, though. Like I said, most people know this because of the free downloads. But the interviews on this site, people don't know about the interviews on this site. People never look at these interviews. They see interviews and they just go past it. The interviews are some of the best interviews on the web. Best interviews on the web. Best. Why am I making this a point to show you guys? Because they are incredibly helpful, these interviews. I go over the entire production process with these professional artists. They all have different answers. They all have great solutions. They all have different ideas that you could try in your musical productions. Example, I give very technical mixing questions to these guys so you can look at them and apply them to your track. I don't just ask them, hey, what's your favorite city to play in? What's your favorite fucking food? No one cares about those questions because they don't help you become a better producer. These interviews have better questions that will help you with your productions than any interview on the fucking web. I feel like that should have been full screen. I feel like that should have been full screen to really give the impact of that. The reason I'm pissed off is because no one, I just got pissed off out of nowhere, because no one fucking looks at these interviews. No one. And these are the best on the web. Literally, when I want to learn production, I go to my own interviews that I created for these artists and apply the information. That's what I do if I want to learn something. I look at my own fucking interviews. Read these interviews. There's artists producing future bass, trap, all different styles, cinematic. They will help you if you look at them, if you read them. So go on to Soundtrack Audio, check out these interviews. You will not be disappointed. I can guarantee you that. Tons of great information in here. Okay. I'm done ranting. But yeah, great track from Yuzu. Really great track. Loved it. Loved it, loved it, loved it. Told you, man. Told you it would be a big hit. So thank you for sending it on in. Do appreciate it. Moving on here. Carlel Hargrove, are you? No. He did not send me a track. Joe Antle, are you in the stream right now? Let me know and we can go over your song. Joe Wepsar, I believe you still are in the stream. No problem, Hamuzu. Happy to help out. So really, honestly, guys, if you could take anything away from this live stream, it would be to go to the interview section on Soundshock Audio and read them and apply the information that you just read. Literally a gold mine of information that you can't find anywhere else on the web. Gold mine. Gold mine. It's gold mine. Gold mine. Wepsar, we still in here or not? Calling Wepsar, I don't believe he is. Again, let me know if you're in the stream and we can go over your song. I will go over someone else's then. Martin Fritz, thank you so much for the follow, man. Do appreciate it. Good to have you on in here. Clemsed, are we in the live stream right now? Clemsed. Good to see you back in here. If you are in here, give me a holla. If you're in here, once again, Clems and Wepsar, you guys are up. Let me know. And we can do it right now. 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 Okay, it looks like neither of you guys are in the stream. Well, that is actually going to do it for this week's live stream then. I want to thank you all for coming on in. Hopefully you are able to get at least one tip from this music production live stream that you can use in your productions right now. Any questions, comments, concerns, feel free to message me. Feel free to message me on SoundShock social media or any of the SoundShock social media. My email address, message me, DM me, message me on Twitch, really anything you guys want to talk about. Music production, Soundtrack Audio. Again, any questions or comments, I'd love to hear from you guys. Always appreciate you guys taking the time to do so. Yes, nice. Check out the interviews. Oh, nice. Also, podcast. Yes, I do have the podcast. Unfortunately, I only have 2 episodes up, and I have not had time to work on the podcast over the last 6 months. And it's something I look to do in the future. That's why I didn't get all angry. I'm like, you should watch this and blah, blah, blah. Because I have not had time to get up a full library of them yet. But yes, these 3 interviews up here, podcasts, are definitely worth listening to. Tons of, again, valuable information that you could use in your productions after listening to them. Again, common theme here is I want to help you guys with your productions. That really is the goal of Soundtrack Audio. So I recommend at least giving my suggestions a try, as I think they will help. Yeah, that's true. Podcasts, you know, podcasts are so much easier to listen to because you can do something else while you're listening to them. So I understand. And again, I do want to work on putting up new podcasts in the future with artists. Well, I ask them a bunch of questions like I do in the interviews. Yeah, that'd be great if you could check out the interviews, as well as, again, tons of information from a very select group of professional producers that are producing at a high level and are producing in many different genres. And again, that is going to do it. Again, we're going to host the live stream every Friday at around 1:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Around 1 to 1:30 Pacific Standard Time. That is 8 to 8:30 p.m. GMT time. Again, I want to thank you all for stopping on by. Some new faces, some returning people. Always good to see the returning faces, as well as the new people in this live stream. Can I hope that I have been helpful in some way to you today? And I hope to see you guys next week with more of your music. Have a great weekend, everyone, and I'll see you later.